Can we talk about what a writer goes through comparing and contrasting how working on a screenplay the first week varies from working on it the last week?
It's much more fun the first week. It's sort of like, again, falling in love. I always use that analogy. My God, you know, it's fantastic. You know, you can't get enough of the person. You know, you can have sex every day. You're always with them. You know, everything you do with them is fantastic. Just looking at them, you're like, oh my God. And then as you continue to work on it, it's still extraordinarily pleasurable, but things start cropping up, right? How do we live? How do we, what practical considerations? Or maybe you start to see some things about them that, you know, maybe you've got to work with, you have to live with. So that's really like writing a script. You have this huge passion for it. But then as you begin to form it into this commercial form, right? This is a commercial art form. But that's delightful. Let's take the, if you have a vanity license plate, we have a lot in California, you got to fit your message in this vanity license plate in 7 letters, right? Every commercial, but the delight of it is that you have this constraint of this 7-letter form. It's witty to figure out that, let's say I saw a Corvette license plate the other day, vanity on the 405, big Corvette, you know, and the vanity license plate said 3 inches. So I thought that was very funny, right? Funny, ha-ha. Why is it funny? Well, if he'd had 80 letters to say it, you know, I have a really tiny penis, maybe that's a little funny, but it's not nearly as funny as 3 inches, right? So it is the constraints of the commercial art form, the delight we take in fitting our story ideas into this constraint, the delight the audience takes in seeing it in that form. So when we constrain, though, we must discipline and we must shape. And that's where it gets dicey for writers. Their second act is a completely different story from the first and the third act. How do we do that? Well, it's a completely different story, but it's related to act one and three. Most writers get in trouble in their second act because they got a great beginning, a great ending, but there's a whole 60 minutes in the middle. They don't really know what's going on. So, and it must be related to the story, but it's involved with a different storyline. So all these things go into movie scripts, and that's where you almost need two talents. Look, I think screenwriting is as hard as brain surgery. In fact, I think it's a little harder. And the myth is that in Hollywood, it's full of stupid people. Dumb people who've just stumbled into their success. They're smoking a spliff by the pool in Malibu. Oh, that's a good script. Ah, let's do that one. And then here comes more money. In my experience, the smartest people I've ever met work in Hollywood. It's a myth that it's full of dumb, angry, jerky people. And it's a myth Hollywood peddles because it's fun. People want to believe that. Entourage is based on that. Other movies are based on that. But it's just not true. Hollywood's full of the smartest people I've ever met. And by the way, a lot of them are really highly moral too. Again, that's not what they peddle because that doesn't sell tickets. People want to believe Hollywood's evil and stupid. That's fine, they can believe that, but it's not. So when you're writing a story, you have to, it's extremely difficult art to conquer. You've got to have at least 3 gifts. You have to have a gift for telling a big story. You have to have a gift for telling a story inside a scene. That's a completely separate art. And then you have to have a gift for putting the two together in a constrained time. Those are 3 separate gifts. It takes a while to learn them. You must have talent too. So, none of this is to discourage anybody from doing this, but I want you to understand that this art is an art that isn't going to come to you all as just a big package that you can just sit down and write it all out. In my experience, most of the time, the writers I work with that are really successful are lacking maybe 1 of those 3, or they have maybe 2 and a little bit of the third, but they don't have it all. So they have a process that they have to go through to learn that last gift. And it can take them 6 months, a year, 2 years, 3 years to do that. Very rare that someone just sits down and their first script that comes out is a commercial hit. It does happen. There's a guy that I've worked with that did do that. but he's an extraordinary exception. He's a guy that has made two hit scripts, one of them in dispute with the director, so I'm not going to give you his name, but you'd know the movies if I told you. But he's the only guy I've ever met who just sat down and produced this golden egg, his first bump out of the gate. And Shakespeare did it. Apparently, they say Shakespeare never blotted a line. I think Marlowe says that about Shakespeare. He never had to go back and do a rewrite. But 99% of the geniuses, quote unquote, I work with, they do rewrites. They do a lot of rewrites. Ron Bass will obsess on a script for months before he lets it out of his sight. And that's the general rule. So it's a difficult craft that takes extraordinary discipline to achieve, usually.